Welcome student, today we are going to start a new lesson, that is conjunction. Here is conjunction. Conjunction is a word in the sentence who perform, or the activity of the conjunction is to join two words, phrases, clauses or sentences. So this is the activity the word conjunction do in the sentence. Okay, so here we get the definition of the conjunctions in the sentence, that a conjunction is a word that joins word, phrases, clauses and sentences with each other. Okay, now look at an examples of the conjunction, how to use the conjunction in the sentence. Okay, here is the first. Here is the first sentence, that is I like to eat bread. I like to eat bread and butter. So in this first sentence, the word and joins two words, that is bread and butter. Bread and butter, these two words are joined by the conjunction is used in the sentence, that is and. Okay, now look at the second sentence. Okay, in the first sentence, as we saw, that the conjunction and joins two words. In the second sentence, we stayed at home because it was raining. So look at the second sentence, we stayed at home is a complete sentence, and second, it was raining is a another sentence, which is complete sentence. We get the complete sense of meaning from these two sentences, but these two sentences are joined with the help of conjunction, that is because. Okay, so here in the second sentence, the two sentences are joined with each other with the use of because. Okay, so because is a word, that is conjunction. Okay, now look at the different functions that conjunctions played in perform in the sentences. So look at the first sentence, that is a coordinating conjunction joins words, phrases, clauses or sentences of a equal importance. Of a equal importance means both sentences are very having the same value or same importance in the after the conjunction, after the using of conjunction. Okay, both sentences are as important as with each others. Okay, or both have a same value in the sentence. Look at the first example, that is he is rich. This is a complete sentence. And another sentence is he is unhappy. He is unhappy. Both sentences are meaningful and full sentences. Okay, so these two sentences having a same value, same importance with each other, like each other. And these two sentences are come together and form a single one sentence with the help of conjunction, that is used in a red word, that is but. So sentence become, he is rich but he is unhappy. Okay, here using while using the but, we joins these two sentences and make one sentence. Okay, so here both these two sentences having equal importance in the sentences. Okay, now look at the second sentence. Sheila ate an apple and Shaila ate a guava. Okay, Sheila ate an apple is a complete sentence. Shaila ate an guava. So both sentences are having equal importance in the sentence after using the conjunction and. Sheila ate an apple एंड शैला एट ए गुआ. ओके, लुक एट द थर्ड वन. लुक एट द थर्ड वन. यू मे स्टे एट होम विथ ग्रैंड मा. यू मे स्टे एट होम विथ ग्रैंड मा और कम विथ अस फॉर द पिकनिक. सो यू मे हियर वाई ओ यू. यू मे इफ वी एड यू मे कम विथ अस फॉर पिकनिक हैविंग द सेम इक्वल इम्पोर्टेंस इन द सेंटेंस दिस सेंटेंस एंड यू मे स्टे एट होम विथ ग्रैंड मा. सो बोथ सेंटेंसेज हैव एन इक्वल इम्पोर्टेंस इन द सेंटेंस. ओके, लुक एट द अनदर वन. वी वेयर टायर्ड येट वी स्टेड अप लेट. ओके, वी स्टेड अप लेट इज अ हैविंग अ कंप्लीट मीनिंग एंड हैविंग एन कंप्लीट सेम इम्पोर्टेंस इन द सेंटेंस एज द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस दैट इज वी वेयर टायर्ड. Another example of using that is he must have eaten too much for he was sick all night. Okay, he was sick all night, complete sentence. He must have eaten too much is a complete sentence. And these two sentences are joined with the conjunction using for. Another word is either give me the book or either or. Okay, I shall complain to mother. Here the conjunction used is either or. The conjunction either or. And another sentence is neither nor. Look at this sentence, neither nor. Okay, either or is a affirmative sentence and neither nor is a negative sentence. Neither was he a doctor nor had he any medical background. Okay, not only but also. Another word, conjunction is not only but also. Not only was the girl intelligent but she was also beautiful. Okay, so in this way the coordinating conjunctions are used in the sentences. Okay, so the another is the subordinating. Okay, one minute. Look at the another sentence that is another type that is subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunction. Okay, look at the definition of the subordinating conjunction. A subordinating conjunction joins clauses or a sentences of unequal importance. Unequal, as we saw, coordinating conjunction, that the both sentences having an equal importance in the sentence forming with the conjunction. But in this type of sentences, that is subordinating conjunction, it joins the clauses or sentences with unequal importance. Means there are two sentences that having unequal importance, or they are having a main clause and subordinate clause in the sentence. Okay, the clause with the subordinating conjunctions is of lesser rank than the other clause, which is the main clause. The subordinate clause depends on the main clause for its meaning. Means here we uses or joins different clauses or different sentence with unequal importance, that the most important sentence are considered as a main clause and the other, which is not as much as importance in the sentence, that is called as a subordinate clause. So in the sentence, subordinate clause depends for full meaning on the main clause. So here is the first example, that the girl is sad. The girl is sad. So here we get the complete sense of meaning. The girl is sad because she has lost her ship.
So in the second sentence, because she has lost her sheep gives us a some kind of meaning that she has lost her sheep. But what happens then? Okay? It depends for the complete meaning on the first sentence, that is girl is sad. Okay? So here the girl is sad is a main clause, and the because she has lost her sheep is subordinate clause. Okay? Look at the second sentence. David will come. David will come. The complete meaning, okay? We get the sense of complete meaning. If he is invited, if he is invited, then what happened? So here we did not get the complete sense of meaning of the sentence. If he is not invited, but we join these sentences with the use of conjunction. If here he is invited, but where and why and how, these questions arise after he is invited. So here we get the some kind of meaning, but not the complete sense of meaning. These sentences or subordinate clause is joined with the main clause with the conjunction used if. Okay, in this way the he is invited is a subordinate clause which is depends on the main clause, that is David will come for getting a complete sense of meaning. So here in the first sentence, the girl is sad is a main clause and she has lost her sheep is a subordinate clause, while in the second sentence, David will come is main clause and he is invited as a subordinate clause. Okay? Look at the some words which are using in the subordinate conjunction. In the subordinate conjunctions, that is till, until, though, although, since, unless, before, when, where, while, after. These type of conjunctions are used in the subordinate conjunction. In the subordinate conjunction, okay? While the other is the conjunctions, that is but and or yet for or either or neither nor not only but also are the coordinating conjunctions, as we saw earlier that they are having two equal important sentences that are joined with the coordinating conjunction. The main clause and subordinate clause are the components of the subordinate conjunctions. Okay? So here we completed this chapter, that is conjunctions. I will send you a photograph of an exercise to complete. Okay? So lesson number 22, you have to complete the exercise and send me a photograph on my number today. Okay? Now we will stop here. Okay?